Good morning, Eisenhower. Today we're very lucky to have Detective Kellogg with us. And Detective Kellogg, thanks very much for being here today.
Good morning. Thank you very much for having me, Mr. Oliar. I appreciate it.
How is Dare going this year?
Dare's going very well this year. Detective Soto, Sergeant Murphy and I are having a good time. The kids are very well behaved, which is a nice thing for us to enjoy. But it's going very well, and we look forward to completing the year out. And I think the kids are learning, too.
Oh, that's great. That's great. Well, today we're here to talk about Internet safety. Things have changed a lot when we were young, and now there's a whole other world out there, and not only do you have to patrol the streets, but you also have to patrol the Internet. Could you tell us a little bit about that and predators and how kids can keep safe?
It's a big part of our job, a lot bigger, Mr. Oliar, than I thought it would be. We not only take reports from our Wyckoff residents about Internet problems, but we have a Bergen County squad that does nothing but Internet safety.
Mm-hmm.
They arrest predators. They're online chatting with potential predators. It becomes a huge part of police work for us, and it's a lot bigger of a job than we thought it would be, I can tell you that.
Mm-hmm. And also, you know, the world has gotten a little different, too. I know when we were kids, if you were angry at somebody or if you didn't like someone, you can sort of say something to them, and it usually sort of stayed between two people. But I know, you know, sometimes kids don't quite understand that the Internet is really a public forum. I know when I was growing up, there was this little saying, you can yell fire, but if you yell fire in a movie theater, it's a whole other kind of different thing. And could you talk to us a little bit about how, you know, the Internet is such a public forum and how important it is to be aware that when you're speaking in that context, you're speaking to a whole world, really?
It is very important. I went to Franklin Ave Middle School and years ago, and when we had bullying or teasing, it was done one-on-one or in small groups, person-to-person. Today we find that still occurs, but the bigger problem is the Internet. The whole world can view what you put on the web. If you type something in your keyboards and you put it up on either a public website, MySpace, Facebook, or one of those type of venues, the whole world will literally have access to it, including your parents, your teachers, and more importantly for our talk this morning, law enforcement. Mm-hmm. Police officers do and can see almost everything you put on the Internet. So it's important to recognize when you're talking about other people, if you wouldn't say it in front of your parents or your teacher or your DARE officer, don't say it on the Internet either.
Yeah. Well, you know, you get the sense that the Internet is so anonymous that no one knows who you are, but I understand that you guys have a lot of tools and techniques to sort of really, you know, find out who posted things. Can you, you know, in terms of like predators and also just in terms of bullying and kids talking to one another on the Internet, how easy is it for you guys to trace that stuff?
It's actually very easy. Every time you go on the Internet, Internet protocol or an IP address is generated. And along with the Bergen County Prosecutor's Office Computer Crimes Unit, we can track that IP address right to your house. Whether you have a wireless server or whether you're hooked up to a cable modem, we can actually trace that right to you. It's very easy. The Bergen County Prosecutor's Office Computer Crimes Unit is about the best on the east coast of our country. So if you put it on the Internet and we want to find out about it, we will. That's the bottom line.
And are there real consequences for kids if they do something wrong on the Internet? Can you tell us about that?
Absolutely. Most of what we talk about, Mr. Oliar, is considered harassment under New Jersey law.
Mm-hmm.
Harassment is a disorderly person's offense. For a kid, you're not going to go to jail, but the potential is you could get a fine, you could get have to go to special classes, you could get a juvenile record. So, there are real consequences for it. And everything that we do in our lives in the police department is tracked. So if we deal with you once, we'll deal with you a second time. We can look back in your history. So it's important, keep a clean slate with us, and you'll be better off in your later in life.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you very much. Is there anything else that we didn't talk about that you think we need to bring up?
I think the kids need to know, too, we always look at it from the perspective of a victim. Anything mm-hmm. I do as a detective in our Wyckoff Police Department, I always look at it from the victim's perspective. And if you have to put yourself, we even try to put ourselves in the shoes of the victims to know how it feels when you're either a victim of a burglary, robbery, or any of the other crimes, but even the Internet harassment. And I wish kids would be able to try to do that for themselves a little bit, put themselves in the victim's shoes a little bit more. And before they do something, think twice about it.
Yeah, that's really good advice. And, you know, I think we really need to keep this in mind. The world has gotten to be a much, much bigger place, and the communication tools that we have are enormous. And not only are we communicating to one-on-one, but we're also communicating to everyone. So please keep that in mind, folks. When you use the Internet, make sure that you keep yourself safe from predators, and also make sure you keep yourself safe from getting involved in problems with harassing or bullying other kids.
And if you do have any questions about anything, you know how to get in touch with either Detective Soto or myself. 891-2121, or WPDDetectives@optonline.net, and we'll answer any questions you may have. If you want to report something or just want to know about Internet safety, please feel free to call us.
Thanks very much for coming in today, and have a good day. And now back to our host, Angela.